phones were ringing off the hook, and I happened to be the lucky one who picked up the line. And basically, baby was coming when I picked up. I mean, you know, you heard mom in the background. And basically, my job was to make sure I got the right address from dad, just try to keep him focused, understand what was going on and what was happening, and basically get the call in immediately and get it up to our police and firemen, the paramedics, to make sure we got the help out there to bring baby into the world.
We're in a command vehicle, which is more like a four-wheel drive truck, and they said, your vehicle is a lower profile, it's got four-wheel drive, and you're the only ones that can get there. So I grabbed Chris, who's my driver for the remainder of the storm, and said, we're going to deliver a baby. And he said, okay. And the team here at the station that we're at started scrambling around, grabbing equipment for us off of the rescue trucks and fire engines here at the station. They gave us an OB kit. They gave us oxygen. They gave us some airway stuff in case we had any issues. And we jumped in the truck, and we were actually very fortunate. The incident commanders were correct that the engines and rescues would not have been able to get through what we had to go through to get to their home. Yeah. So Chris is an expert driver, and he got us through there safely and quickly. And we pulled up, and we were not expecting what we saw. When we got there, she was pretty much almost all the way out. And she was, and her, the patient's mother, the mother of the person in labor, was actually pretty much delivering the baby, her own granddaughter, in the bathroom on the floor.
Wow.
And I've never met or seen a more calm scene in the chaos that was going on outside. We were kind of taken back by it. Looked like a labor and delivery room, and everybody was extremely calm, and everybody was smiling, and it was very calming to Chris and I to walk into that non-chaotic scene and then start doing what we had to do.
We clamped the cord and cut the cord, and baby wasn't presenting really good at first, but she pinked right up. You know, it was a beautiful little baby.
Yeah. How are the mom and baby doing now?
They're doing great. We checked on them. She hugged us all before we left, and we told her we had to go because we had other emergencies we needed to take care of, and she didn't want us to leave and told us to please come back to the house and see the baby after all this, and we promised her we would.